지금까지 쭉 해온 것은 강의해온 것은 바로 이것을 이 말씀을 여러분이 꼭 기억하게 하시기 위한 강의였습니다.
What the essence of what we have learned so far is in this text. Counsels on Health, page 29, says, "The love which Christ diffuses through the whole being is a vitalizing power. Every vital part, the brain, the heart, the nerves, it touches with healing. By it, the highest energies of the being are aroused to activity." Now here, vitalizing power is the energy of God. Yeah, the Bible, the Hebrews says the Word of God has the energy, the moving. The breath of life. The breath of life, the power of God, vitalizing power, can make the dead live. Like when God created a human being, created a dust, you know, created a man out of the dust. That dust, the dead being, became a living being because of the breath of life, vitalizing power. That is actually the Ministry of Healing, page 115. Ministry of Healing, 115.
By it, the highest energies of the being are aroused to activity. 그래서 이것으로 이 에너지로 말미암아 우리 각 사람들 안에서 이 최고의 에너지도 여러 에너지들이 있지 않습니까? 그냥 전기 에너지, 비디 에너지, 뭐 이런 에너지 있지만은 이 생명 에너지.
You know there are many kinds of energies like light energy and the electric energy and all kinds of energies, but this energy that we're talking about, this is the highest energy that we're talking about. God's energy is the highest energy. You know, physical energy cannot change the heart of man. But this energy, this highest energies of the being are aroused to activity. This highest energy comes from God. Now here, the love in the word of Jesus Christ is a vitalizing power. That's what it is. That's what it means. Remember this. The love is a vitalizing power. The love, the word of God, it's the vitalizing power. When we recognize this specifically, you know, if you just get into the theoretically, it doesn't work. But you need to experience this vitalizing power in you. Then you would be so sure about this vitalizing power, which is from the love of God. Like Ellen G. White, she said she felt this very strong electric shock in her body. And then she said, the pain that she had, they all disappeared. Remember this 12 years old? This lady, that woman in the crowd, suffered for 12 years with constant bleeding. She also felt in her body that she was healed instantly. Yes, this is the practical theology. Now, Counsels on Health, page 29, it frees the soul from the guilt and sorrow, the anxiety and care that crush the life forces. Yeah, it frees the soul.
모든 이런 불안감이나 죄책감이나 슬픔이나 이런 걱정들은 뭐를 crush한다?
You know that guilt feelings or the sorrow and the anxiety and the care, that kind of feelings, they crush the life forces. Yeah, they crush the life forces, life power, life energies. But the love, which is the word of God, will give us freedom, will free us from this. Remember, the word is life, and the love is life. The word of God is life, and the love is life. Is there any way to express this idea? The character of God is life. The character of God is also life. Now we say God is love, and the love, yes, the love is the character of Jesus Christ. Now please meditate upon this word, that the character of God is life, and the character of God is love. Please listen careful, and I'll give you those answers during the lecture. So please remember this. The character of God is life. You should remember this. Have it in your mind. Keep it in your mind. And listen to the lecture, and you will have a good understanding. This concept, the character of God is life, is very important. Today we're going to talk about autoimmune disease in a theological way. We're going to talk about what those autoimmune diseases are and how can those diseases be healed theologically. Why? Because those autoimmune diseases, they cannot be healed medically. Well, actually, there's none. You cannot be cured medically. But only the life from the Lord, only Jesus Christ can heal the diseases. When you listen to this, you are not supposed to listen to this just religiously, but just remember that this is also very true in scientific ways. Autoimmune diseases, auto means, you know, automatically. You know, we have this immune system in our body. Our immune systems, they protect our body from different kinds, different forms of diseases. You know, there are several kinds of cells which are responsible for our health, and those cells we call immune cells. Immune cells, they have immunofunction. It means when the germs come inside our body, then they destroy the, you know, bad germs. And when the cancer cells growing, they kill the cancer cells. They boost up our immune system to have good health. So that's what the immune cells are doing. Now, we also call this the power of immune system. We say your immune system is good, means that person have that person's immune cells, they have strong power to resist those diseases. You know, immune cells, when we say you have a good immune system or immune power to protect ourselves, what do you call that? It means those immune cells that they're supposed, well, those immune cells are doing their jobs. Now, that immune function, where does it come from? Now, those function, of course, there is pre-programmed, there's a program in immune cell. Of course, not only one program, but there are many programs in the immune cell to protect our body. And where is that program? That is in the gene of immune cells. In the immune cells, there is gene, and in this gene, there is a program to protect our body. In the gene, there are many programs in the cell to produce some substances to destroy those bad cells. Well, immune cells, we call this white blood cell. Red blood cells, they have no immune power, but then white blood cells has this immune system. They're responsible for the immune program. And then, as you know, T lymphocyte, T cells, they are responsible for that immunoaction or function. They take the main role in immune system. You know those white thing, that they are the T cells, and the big one, that's the cancer cell. In the T cell, there's a lot of programs to kill the virus, to kill the fungus. If this program is not working, then you have, you know, athlete's foot. It's not, when the genes is turned off, which kills this fungus, then you have athlete's foot. So even though you take a lot of medicine to kill this fungus, or you put the ointments or whatever, it doesn't work. It's because the genes are turned off. As long as genes are turned off, even though you take medicine, it's not going to work. Maybe it seems you're getting better, but it's not going to be healed. The genes should be turned on. Now, when your T cell is very weak, then because they are the headquarters of the immune system, you get lots of diseases. When I say those T cells get weak, what does that mean? It means when the programs are all turned off, when the genes are turned off, then your immune system is getting low. Now, when those immune systems are all turned off, then you die. But let's say a great number of immune systems or the genes are turned off. Why? Why is because the life energy is blocked. Why? Because you have this sorrow, anger, and guilt, and those problems and troublesome thinking, they crush the life energy. Remember that what we have read in Counsels on Health? But when the life of God comes into us, then it will free us from these worldly thinking or the anger or the guilt, you know, those kind of feelings. So remember that. Now let's say, you know, you may pray this, like, God, please send your light energy or life energy into my turned off genes so that they can be turned on and activate their function. You know, you need to pray specifically. You know, theory is not all because they don't have the real concept. So practically, when you pray in this way, God will send us this life wave, life energy into us. To specify the concept, I made this word, this life wave. Maybe it can be a blasphemy, because, you know, this is this kind of neo language or the word neo word I make, maybe that can be a blasphemy to God. But, you know, I made those word for you to understand specifically and practically, realistically, because I want you to have a very sure ideas. I'm not saying I am this kind of a philosopher or I am this scholar, you know, to make all these words up, but, you know, it's not like that. You know, when I say wave, it's like I am degrading the power of the Holy Spirit when I say the life way or the spirit way. But I just want you to understand so that I made these words up to level with us or the people. Well, you asked me that those righteous people, you see, like good people or the religious people, sometimes they die even though they practice, you start, they read the Bible and, you know, their life is so wonderful, but then they die of cancer. Then what does that mean? Well, then my answer is 2 Corinthians chapter 12. Remember, Satan asked for that life. And also there's another answer, but I'll get into this later. Now, if you ask me that because they didn't exercise, even though they practiced, they're very religious, but because they didn't exercise, they died. Well, if you ask me this way, then I say, well, if you say you practice New Star, you just can help exercising. You know, when you exercise, it's like it's the time for praying. You know, if you think exercise is just exercise, that's not new start. Whatever it is, if there is no God, then it's just a fact. You know, Yosemite National Park, the waterfall, can be just the water out of the rocks if there is no God, you know. But if there is God, then you see this waterfall and you know that, ah, that's the love of God. And that's the real new start. Now you ask many things about exercise. Now, let me explain in this way. There is this woman saying, Dr. Lee, my husband is so picky about clothes and everything, so he doesn't wear a shirt twice, even though it is clean. I think it's clean, but he doesn't wear it because he wore this once. You know, when she irons, when you iron, yeah, you have this sweat. But for this lady, ironing is not an exercise. It's a stress for this lady. And there's another lady came and she said, Dr. Lee, you know, I love ironing. Every time I iron the shirt, every time I iron the shirt from my husband, you know, those wrinkles get straightened up. And I added water and they steamed and they straightened out. And then I pray that God send me the Holy Spirit and give me this water of the Holy Spirit, then my wrinkled hearts will be straightened up. So Lord, please send your Holy Spirit in my heart. Well, that kind of ironing, that I think that is an exercise. So without God, it's nothing. So many people think in this way, so actually they are not practicing new start. Many people think in this way, I mean the first lady's way, so they haven't practiced new start. I don't know, if you tell me this religious people practiced new start, when you say this religious people practiced new start, I don't know how they think about New Start and what was their practice, I don't know. If you just think that New Start is eat the healthy vegetarian diet and exercise and drink water, you know, those factual things without God, then that is not New Start. Let's say if you didn't exercise or if you didn't eat a healthy diet, then you feel guilty. You know, that is not the spiritual new start. That is flesh. You know, Jesus said, the spirit only gives eternal life, and the flesh is useless. You know, this truth in the word, you have to really, really understand this. And Jesus said, I have spoken to you. The word I have spoken to you is the truth and the life. Not the word from other people, but the word from the mouth of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ has the true character. The character of Jesus Christ is life, I said. So Jesus only has this character. Now Jesus said, one of you would sell me When Jesus said, that is life. Judah, please don't. I love you, Judah. Please don't sell me. When Jesus says, that's the life. This is what it means. But when other people say, one of you will sell me, do something. Do something for that, with it. It's the word that Jesus Christ have spoken to us. That's the life and the truth. It's not about the word, but the speaker is the truth. Because the speaker, Jesus Christ, is the truth. Whatever he speaks is the truth. When the speaker is the truth, is the life. Remember, we go back again. The character of Jesus is life. It's very important. The character of God is life. When the T cell gets weak, when I say the T cell is weak, it means the genes, the program of God's plan, these genes haven't received this life energy. Why? Because these genes are blocked and, you know, infrastructure is not provided properly. Then you will have some kinds of allergy. When your immune system is low, your body is feels unstable. So inside of your body, there is overprotection reaction, which is like the overprotection. When your T cell is very strong, in your subconscious, you have this confidence that like you're fine. But then when the T cell is weak, your body reacts overly. So when you're tired, exhausted, if you overwork, when you're stressed, the life energy is blocked and the T cells are, you know, weak and the genes are turned off, and then you started to sneeze and you feel like, oh, maybe I'll catch a cold. It means your T cells very weak and your genes are turned off. That's what it means. Your immune system is low. That's what it means. When the immune system is good, you know, something bad, you know, comes inside our body, but then you just like, it's fine. You come in, but my T cells will take care of this. We have this power. You know, that level, they're in that level, so your body doesn't react overly. But when your immune system is low and the T cells and those genes in the T cells are turned off, then you react overly. You're exhausted, you're stressed. Then we need to rest. We drink water and have healthy diet, and the word of God, you know, touches your genes and your genes are turned on, then you don't sneeze anymore. So allergies, okay, those kind of allergies, they happen all because of that. Me personally, I had a lot of problems with bronchitis. You know, I was a specialist in asthma, but anyway, after I became an Adventist, I became fine. I thought I couldn't make the patients get better, and I thought I couldn't make myself even get better. But through the Word of God and through practicing the New Start, I became fine. I experienced it in my body. Now, T cells, they attack the cancer cells and they can destroy those cancer cells. Well, this is the immune reaction function. This is the function of the immune system. Now, autoimmune diseases, well, it's because this T cells are confused. They get this autoimmune disease. Here, when I say confused, it means the program, let's say program got broken. If you compare this, not enough electricity is provided. So, you know, this T cells didn't get enough power, or a T cell is broken. That's why you have autoimmune disease. When the programs in the T cell got broke down, they become confused and they start attack themselves, like our body. The change of the program, the change of the genes attack yourself, like your T cells attack yourself. According to where those T cells attack inside of your body, you know, these autoimmune diseases, they have different names. When the T cells attack your knee area, they call this rheumatoid. When they attack thyroid, then they have this thyroid problems. If they attack your hair cell, then you know you have this bald part of your hair, you know, head, then you also have that. If they attack, you know, renal area, then autoimmune renal deficiency. You know, let's say Parkinson's disease that we talked about yesterday, you know, they attacked dopamine, you know, genes, and then dopamine is not produced, and they have this Parkinson's disease. Now, lupus. Now, when the T cells attack our capillaries, then they have this lupus. You know, our capillaries are all over inside our body. So according to where the T cells attack, the names can be changed. You know, glaucoma and others, they all are a kind of autoimmune disease. And also Crohn's disease. You know, and then T cell attacks your stomach, intestines. And when the T cell attacks your liver, you have this hepatitis. And A Lugeric disease is when the T cell attacks your motor system, and you have dry mouth and you have dry eyes. They're all autoimmune disease because T cells attack that area. So you have to, you know, use this artificial eye drops to wet your eyes. Let's say this is the neuron, and the neuron, and there is a muscle, and they contact there, you know, neuromuscular junction, we call that area. Neuromuscular, we call it NM junction. When the T cell attacks that NM junction, then your muscles, they lose power. Now this student here, he had that problem. In the hospital, they say, you know, he's going to die. Well, because you have this problem, you couldn't even open your eyes. Why? Because, you know, this neuron, you know, they should send the electric current to the muscle so that eyes will be open. But then he couldn't, you know, his neurons couldn't work, so he couldn't even open his eyes. And, you know, he looks very exhausted. It's because his muscles are all down. When your muscles don't work, you know, they don't function, so it can be very dangerous. Let's say if when the T cells attack this certain cell, which has the hair in the on the body, if the T cell attacks there, then you have just all the hair falls out of your body. Well, in Korea, before, we didn't have this kind of disease. But now they have a lot. The reason why these kind of autoimmune diseases arise is because this T cell, which was controlled by God, or the energy of God, they somehow got confused and they start attack the body instead of protecting. Why is that? You know, I have emphasized this, that when the spirit, when the wave life or the spirit wave comes to us, we have this brain wave which corresponds to this brain, to this spirit wave. And then now our brain wave, according to the brain wave, we have this special substance. To convey substances which conveys to the cell. Signal transduction system, that's what we call in medicine. Signal transduction system. Remember this picture? Cell communication here now. Let's say you looked at this wonderful, beautiful landscape, and this wave of beauty, wave of truth, the God's wave, comes to the brain, and then it activated this endorphin genes, and then endorphins produced these things, and this endorphin genes, I mean endorphin, the substances, they have its own wave, and this wave is connected to this receptors of the T cell in the bloodstream. And when the wave is conveyed in the receptor, it will be amplified in the bloodstreams, and that will get into the T cell. And this T cell, genes in the T cell, and these genes, when the genes turned on, and it will produce some substances to destroy the cancer cells or the fungus or the virus to protect ourselves. So this thankfulness or the truth or the goodness, when you recognize this, oh, what a wretched man I am, but God loves me so much. So when you become thankful and you are so thankful for the character of God, when you are so happy looking at the beautiful nature that God has created for us. Now these kind of things will become the spirit wave. So you know, these are the word of God. So these word of God, you know, becomes this biologically also their energy. Because his spirit, you know, remember from the waves, it became, produced this substance and this substance. So it became the protein, this special substance, which is protein, to destroy. So physiologically, medically, theologically, they're all true. But they are one truth. It's not different or the separated. So when you break the law of God, it's like you break the law of biological body as well. That's what the Ellen G. White said. So T cells are very sensitive to their brain function. Well, our brain, they react to the spirit wave. So what kind of spirit, what kind of message is connected or conveyed to the brain, our body changes. You know, our brain has this electric reaction. So when you think of these worries or difficulties, your brain makes this beta wave. But when you are touched and inspired by the word of God, you have this alpha wave. When you breathe this fresh, clean air, your brain makes alpha wave. When you listen to the beautiful music, you have this alpha wave. When you think of the love of your grandmother or grandfather, you have this alpha wave. You have this electric change in your body. You know, your T cell, however, yes, your T cell instantly reacts to the change of your brain. So some scientists say our T cells instantly react to the brain.
Nakata.
So instead of some scientists, they say instead of calling those T cells like the cells, they say T cells should be the pieces of some kind of pieces in the brain. They decided to call this. Well, this is how God created us. This is theobiology. Theobiology is very easy to explain now if you understand this mechanism, because that's how we're created, and that's how God created us. Before, psychology is a totally different part, because they thought this is just about the mind. They thought psychology has nothing to do with biology, because psychology is just the way of thinking. But actually, psychology, it talks about our mind, so you know, they study T cells. You know, immunology, they study immune system and T cells, but somehow people thought, or the scientists thought, psychology, immunology has nothing to do with. But then recently, they realized that, oh, they are related. Why? It's because according to the state or the feelings of our mind, anger, hatred, happiness, satisfaction, you know, on the surface of the T cell, there are many receptors to receive those kind of feelings of our mind, you know, like the anger, hatred, and satisfaction, and happiness. So T cells have this a lot of receptors on their surface so that it can receive that feeling or the state of mind.
Immunology, psychology.
So you know what happened these days? They decided to combine, so they say psychoimmunology. Not psychology, immunology, but then they decided to combine psychoimmunology. This is what the world is going for. And psychology these days, they usually combine with other studies. Why? Because now everybody knows that the change of the mind influences the change of the body. So even popular or famous universities, they don't have like psychology department only, but then they have psychobiology or biopsychology or psychoimmunology. The psychology is combined with other study. Now this class that I am teaching now here, we can call this class theobiology, or you can say biotheology. To make you happy, I can say theobiology because you're all theologians here. Well, theobiology is correct. Well, God is controlling this biological reaction in our body. So theobiology is correct. No, scientists or the people, they have reached to the psychology level. They haven't been to the God's level, but our job, we have to connect God's spirit. We have to reach to that part. We have to prove medically, scientifically how God, how the Spirit of God is related to our health. Remember John chapter 13, verse 12, I said the devil had already prompted Judah, the son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. It's not about Judas, but the devil gave Judas this thought to sell Jesus. Well, psychologists think, well, this is just what Judah thought. It's not about the devil. But Sister White said, we are the human machine. We're like the machine. Remember the TV set? According to the frequencies, the TV has different channels. So, you know, according to the frequencies, according to the waves, what kind of spirit receive, we are different people. When we understand this, we know that righteousness by faith is so clear. The reason why we're so confused in between righteousness by faith and righteousness by work is because we are lacking this idea of human, you know, machine, and also we are lacking an understanding of the free will. When Satan gives this message into Judah's head, well, Judah accepted that message with his free will. Satan also gives that kind of Sorry, we had some technical problems. We had some technical problems, so there was this connection. You know, we can reject God's call or God's words with our free will. Now, let's say there's a woman and she flirts with me, and you decide, like, you're going to leave your wife. If you think like this way, the system of your body, you know, gets low. Sister White said his character, the person, this man's character, was against the law of life. Because of the character which was from Satan, it can destroy or it can break down the law of life. So when you think of this kind of immoral thinking or ideas, when you think this kind of way, you know, immoral way of thinking, your life energy is blocked. You know, see, this is the giraffe. The giraffe is eating this bone. And that was very strange for the scientist to see this. So the scientists, they took the blood out of the giraffe and they found that this giraffe is lacking calcium. Well, giraffe, they don't know what calcium is. Only God knows. This giraffe is lacking calcium in its blood. Then, you know, God sends this spirit wave to this giraffe. You know, giraffe just cannot help eating the bone. Well, giraffe, they don't have the free will, so they just obey what God says. But we, human beings, we don't obey. You know you don't obey God. Especially when you eat, like God says, hey, why don't you stop eating here? Animals, they stop eating when they're full. Okay? But even though we're pastors, you guys keep eating. You know, we have this free will, so we can choose. We have this power of choice, so we feel like we have this power to choose. You know, we can have this power of choice, only this power of choice. That's the power that we can perform only. Now let's say this woman, she hates tomatoes. She hates spaghetti. Whatever related with tomatoes, she hates. Somehow she met this man, met a man, and she, you know, started to date with him. But however, this man loves tomatoes. You know, finally, so and so, gradually, they got married. And now this woman got pregnant, but somehow she feels like she wants to eat tomatoes. It's not her free will. Well, she wants to have tomatoes somehow, and she felt so strange because I don't like tomatoes, but somehow why am I going for this tomatoes? Now that God is telling her, like what God is talking to the giraffe. Now let's look at this monkey. This is the article from the National Geography. This monkey lives on the island. They eat a certain type of leaves. This leaves called macumba. Macumba shrubs. They eat this macumba shrub. They don't really eat this a lot, but after they eat this leaves, they go down to the village where the natives live. You know, natives, they cut this tree and then inside they, you know, burn the inside, so they made this charcoal. You know, God put this thought to eat this charcoal to this monkey's head. God put this idea to eat the bone to the giraffe. God put this thought to sell Jesus to Judah's head. Now, macumba shrubs, it has this poison, certain poison. Of course, this monkey doesn't know it has poison. But somehow, after they eat this shrubs, they go down to the village and eat the charcoal. So the scientists take the blood out of this monkey and found out that this leaves have poison. It's a poisonous shrubs. And people, when they see this, people think it's instinct. That's instinct, they say. And instinct, when we talk about instinct, we think it's automatically programmed in their head, but it's not. God should sense the life way. Well, here, instinct here, the pre-program, that's the God's power. People just say instinct, but that's the power from God. You know, baby kangaroos? When they are out of the mother's womb, they go to the pocket. When they're out of the mother's womb, they, you know, go to their mother's pocket. And they can, you can call this is instinct. Is that the instinct? If you just overlook in this way, no, it doesn't make sense. Nonsense. Because the, just the baby is like the finger, you know, size, very small, but then it crawls up the mother's pocket and then gets inside of the mother's pocket. How come? Is that only instinct? It's like the turtling. You know, they go to the sea where their mothers are. That all God is doing. When we say this is what the God is doing, then we glorify God and we worship God. And that's the first angel's message. The first angel's message is to remember your Creator and glorify Him. But then we say, well, glorify God's name or remember your God is to keep the Sabbath. Yeah, of course, that's one of them. But if you just say, keep the Sabbath, is to remember God, it's not. Remember this, you are the creatures. You are the human machine. Every function, those vitalizing power is from God, and God is in control over everything. While I am alive is because God exists. So you glorify God's name and you praise God's name and you worship God because you know that you're alive. You're alive, it means God makes you alive. And that's why you glorify God's name. You thought some things happened automatically, but actually it was not. God was controlling everything. Well, you thought these things, you know, happening or reaction in your body, you thought you're doing it naturally. You thought it was doing it. It was done by, you know, this kind of natural way, but God was controlling each cell and each genes. So it was all because of God that we exist. And then now you remember God and, oh Lord, our Creator. And then you become united with the Creator and then creature. And that's the three angels' messages. Well, you have explained this first angel and second angel and the third angel just in a religious way. Because you say, remember your Creator and the worship God. So, oh, the Sabbath day is the celebration of the creation and we have to remember this and so. So just we have to remember this Sabbath. And Sabbath is very important. But actually, that is not all. Every thinking, every thought should be from God.